was sort of a collaborative effort. It was Louise and these group of people, Susan Cooper, Laura Tannen, and I think Harold Coda, and a few people that Louise, were friends of Louise, and they helped her realize this thing. It was only given once at the Hamilton Gallery. And in it, in a strange way, is that people parade around in these costumes, and there was, you know, sort of polymorphous, perverse sexuality and humor and banter and all that with the MC talking. There was a script at the time. But I think on one aspect it had a lot to do with the sculpture being like body and body parts, and Louise would wear some of her sculpture around her, so it had that component to give animation to her forms. On the other hand, it had to do with her teasing and making fun. I mean, Louise grew up in the world of art historians, and she thought they were pretty pompous, and so she really wanted to trap one, and so she invited Gert Schiff. Now, he didn't realize it, but Gert Schiff was delighted to be in this thing, and he was very vain, and Louise thought, oh, here I captured the vanity of this person. And it was sort of her sort of revenge in terms of art historians and art history, their pomposity and their vanity. What's amazing about Louise has this very strong classical education, so she was actually fascinated in art history on one level, but the other hand, she dislikes art history because she thinks it's used to justify the visual experience, and Louise feels that the work doesn't need that, and she thinks history is something else. I mean, that's the thing about Louise, is she could very easily separate art and art history. Most people sort of conjoin them in some way, and she's saying, no, like, I think Duchamp's urinal would be important for art history, but she goes, I don't want to look at it. I don't get any satisfaction. I keep looking at this urinal, but it is an important thing. So she separates art history. And Louise never played to art history. She had a beautiful saying like, oh, I know, I'm just a rock in the wall, you know, just a big rock wall. I'm just this one rock there. So I think it was her relationship to art history that also enters this piece. So you have all these various threads sort of coming together in this one sculptural form.